This is Pastor Richard, and you are watching Anchored in Christ, a weekly vlog from St. Paul's Lutheran Church to know what we believe and why we believe it to be Anchored in Christ's Word for us. This week we're looking at Matthew chapter 5, those very famous verses and words of Jesus, the Beatitudes, as he speaks and teaches these Beatitudes to us. Now, let's just pull that throttle back a little bit and examine a couple of these verses here. Verses 3 through 6, we read the following. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Now, when I read these verses, I'm always brought back to a lesson given by a pastor in a classroom setting many, many years ago. And he had four individuals line up. And he said, you know, what's the opposite of being spiritually poor or being poor? Well, it's to be rich. And so he gave them a bunch of money and he had that person hold up that money and they're holding that money up to their face. And he went to the next person. He said, well, what's the opposite of mourning? Well, it's to be happy. So he had a little cupcake that they held and they were happy. And then he went to the third person. He said, what's the opposite of being meek? Well, it's to be strong. He said, a couple of dumbbells and they held those dumbbells. And then the fourth person, he said, well, what's the opposite of being hungry, it's to be satisfied. And he took a bunch of Snickers and they held those Snickers to his hands. And then he used this illustration where he had some Skittles and he said, no, imagine these Skittles represent God's gift of his grace, his forgiveness for everyone. And so then he came up to each individual and he took those Skittles and he tried to pour them into the person's hands. But as you can tell, well, that person who had the money and the person who had the Snickers, the person who had those dumbbells and the person that cape, that cake in their hands, all those Skittles were not able to be received by them and they fell all the floor. And he said, you know what? They're not blessed. Then he had another person came up and he said to that person, you're going to represent a person who is spiritually bankrupt, somebody who is meek and somebody who's mourning over their sin, somebody who is spiritually hungry, just at the end of the ropes. And he had them get on their knees with open hands like a beggar. And then he came over and he poured Skittles into their hands and he said, that person right there, he is blessed. You see, when you think about it, in the scriptures, we see a picture of this in all of these miracles that Jesus does. We think of blind Bartimaeus, you know, coming before Jesus. Over and over in the Gospels, we see this reverence, which is an act of worship, where they're on their knees before Christ with open hands to receive. And Christ says that is great faith, faith that clings to Jesus, faith that receives gifts. And so when we think about this, the Christian faith actually runs the opposite way of the rest of the world. When the world seeks to be strong, we say, you know what? When we're meek, we are in a great position. We're blessed because we can receive. The world will strive after being spiritually rich, but we say when we're spiritually poor, we're in a position to receive God's grace. It is always that Kyrie, Lord have mercy, Christ have mercy, Lord have mercy on us, receiving God's gifts. So as we tackle this text for our children and teach it to our children, we're always showing them that it is to be in that beggarly position is what it means to be a Christian, always receiving, always hearing with our ears, always receiving those gifts that the Lord has for us. So I hope this helps, and we'll catch you next time.